Welcome to viewers across Australia and New Zealand. Tonight's concert at the Sydney Entertainment Centre is certainly going to be a major event. It is the final concert of an extraordinary world tour by one of the world's hottest bands, Dire Straits. Over the past 12 months, they have toured 25 countries and have performed to an amazing 260 sell-out concerts. In Australia and New Zealand alone, they have performed to over 1 million people. Tonight, through the faculty, through the facilities of the Nine Network in Australia and on TV One Network throughout New Zealand, millions more will be able to witness this brilliant, and I mean brilliant, band in concert in a live-to-air link-up on over 150 stations. The music of Dire Straits covers all ages from 6 to 60, and since the release of their first album in 1978, which was simply titled Dire Straits, their music has been heard on almost every radio station in the Western world, and even, I might add, in many radio stations in the Eastern Bloc and the Third World countries. Their smash hit, Sultans of Swing, made them a household name worldwide. Since then, they have produced 5 albums. Their latest, Brothers in Arms, which was released about a year ago, shot to number 1 nationally the first week of release on the Australian album charts. It has remained there and remained for about 32 weeks, and that's the longest any album has ever stayed on the number 1 position in the history of Australia's charts. Brothers in Arms has sold worldwide over 12 million copies, and believe me, that is some feat. Dire Straits is a class band with some of the best musicians in the world, and their influence is covering a broad spectrum of music from contemporary rock to classical. So to all of you Australians and New Zealanders, again welcome. And let me remind you, after this concert, and during this concert, is a simulcast wherever possible through your local FM or AM stereo station. And I strongly suggest that you do yourself a favour and tune in, turn up for this great musical experience. Right now I'm leaving to go backstage to talk to Mark Knopfler just prior to introducing this fantastic band live in concert for their final performance of the world tour. It's going to be a Dire Straits concert tonight that you've never seen before. We'll be right back after this commercial break. We'll see you then. Hey. After a very nervous intro, I'm now in the dressing rooms of Dire Straits, and it gives me great pleasure to introduce Mark Knopfler. Mark, welcome to tonight. Who's the joker sitting next to you, incidentally?
I don't know.
I've seen him hanging around the table for some... Excuse me? No. Ed, the manager of Dire Straits.
Hello.
Had to get in first.
That's who you are.
Hello.
Nice to meet you at last.
All right, now listen, down to the serious side. How do you and the band feel?
we're such jokers.
Now, how do you feel that it's the sort of the last concert of this world tour? It's really come to an end.
Well, I think it's mixed feelings all around. You know, the road crew have been coming in like old retainers, you know, leaving for, you know, they've been with you for a long time. Well, it's very weird because, I mean, everybody, you're very conscious of the fact there's a lot of guys that have been putting all their talents and their abilities together to make something work for everybody, and they've done a really great job for us, for the band.
Well, I mean, as a dole.
No, they're not.
But as I said, it's spanned 25 countries in the last year and 260 concerts. When you first put this tour together and thinking of doing a world tour, did you imagine it to be this big?
No.
And to go for so long?
No. I think it was originally about 6 months, and it just grew.
I mean, like when you were telling me just before you were coming out here in LA, you said, I've planned 6 or 7 concerts at the Entertainment Centre in Sydney. It turned out to be 20. Yeah. I think it was about 7 in Melbourne. It turned out to be, 13?
13, yeah.
It just seemed to go on and on. Mm. I mean, did ever get to a stage, just even in this part of the Australasian tour, New Zealand and Australia, that it'd be another day and you'd think, my God, I've got to go and play again tonight. Did the band yourselves ever feel jaded, Stage?
Yeah, I think if you're doing a long stretch in one place, like 20 nights here in Sydney, you know, you get the feeling that you should have a clocking in machine, you should just be coming after a while.
Right.
And you have to do certain things to try and break the monotony. And we've managed to do that all right, I think. And I think the band's been playing better all the time as well, which is very surprising all around. That the standards have been kept, we've been able to maintain standards all the way through and find new things in the music all the time. The other thing is that I'm very proud of the band and the crew for getting the whole thing sorted out, is the fact that there's a lot of fans there that come in to see the band who aren't necessarily a rock and roll, the fans that would be used to having just a seething mass of real rock and roll fans in there. There's a lot of other people coming in that I mean, we, for want of a better word, you kind of call them the tourists.
Mm.
But they're just curious, that sort of, I'll go and have a look at this, I must see what all the fuss is about. And it's nice to turn them on to it, turn them around during the course of a night.
Well, also with the bands, I mean, a lot of bands sort of say, like, after spending, you know, so much time in a recording studio, and then they have to go out on the road, that it becomes a strain on the band because the members are seeing each other every day. I mean, has there ever been any sort of strain on this band?
Well, we're very hot on the fact that your feet haven't got to smell on the bus, and, you know, that you keep your... what do you make of faces?
For yourself.
We're very... it is kind of like a marriage, I guess, in a way.
Mm. It's funny, just before you came in,
I
was saying that there hasn't been a single fight or even major disagreement between anybody within the crew or within the band.
Right, now, I won't ask you this, I'll ask Ed. Normally the band don't like doing television, and now you're doing like an entire live performance. Mm. What motivated you to do that?
Well, one of the reasons it's live. Right. Most television isn't live. And I think that, you know, that process of... you know, the pop TV show where you're miming is boring, but it's nice to be able to thank the people in Australia and New Zealand for the
too,
tour, you know.
Yeah.
It's really that, and it's also for the drug offence campaign.
Right, like, one criticism, if there's been any criticism of the show, and it's a criticism that was also levelled at the Sting show, is that both you and Sting don't talk that much on stage. What's your thoughts on that?
You know, I haven't really thought that much about it. Sometimes, I've been known to, sometimes, you know. I haven't really thought about
it. Whereas other people say, why should they talk on stage? The music speaks for itself.
Well, you said it.
So it's a question of performance style,
right.
I think.
All right.
The thing is, you want the thing to flow a bit. You don't want to keep breaking it up with, or too much of this.
Well, listen, we've got 12,000 people out there ready to fire into action as soon as you walk out on stage. We've got millions of viewers in Australia, New Zealand, ready to watch this, a very important telecast, simulcast. Just one last question. It's a very important concert because some of this money of tonight is going to a great cause. All of it is going to such a great cause. Whose idea was that? Collectively, the band?
Yes, I mean, we were made aware when we came to Australia about the drug problem here and the fact that this campaign was about to start. And it seemed, I mean, Australia's given, and New Zealand, have given a lot to us.
Well,
so it's nice to be able to give something back.
Well,
I hope the campaign
that'll
works.
That'll be explained throughout the telecast. Why don't you hold you up to all the boys. Have a great night. And Mark, have a great night. And thank you very much for coming.
Again.
And for you?
Molly, it's always been a thrill.
Same here, mate.
All right, cheers.
We'll be back in a moment.
Same old story with a different name. stubborn as the day follow the night. The right become wrong, the left become the right. Then they sing as they march away, the flags on fire. Today in the mountains, tomorrow the wild. Why they cross the river? Thank you. get the perfume in her dust. And she come out in the night time with a honeysuckle on us. Oh, and it smells just like home. It tastes like a peach now. She got me walking where the wildlife go. I knew when I turned to reach her, she was making heaven.
struck away with foam and got the theme. Everyone concerned about industrial disease. Panic on the switchboard, tongues in knots. Some command sympathy and some command spots. Some do the management, some the employee. Everybody knows the same industrial disease. Oh, panic. Is disgusted, downs, tools, and walls. Innocence is injured, experience just talks. Everyone's standards and everyone agrees. These are classic symptoms of your monetary squeeze. ITV, BBC, talk about the curse. Philosophy useless, theology worse. History was over, there's an economics free. Sociologists in man word. Main industrial. Parkinson declared, I am not surprised to see you here. Got smokers caught from smoking, brewers stripped from drinking beer. Don't know how you came to get those knees, but worst of all, young man, you've got industrial disease. Wrote me a prescription, he said, you're just depressed. I'm glad you came to see me, get this off your chest. Come back and see me later, next patient please. Send it on the victim of industrial disease. Speaker's corner sucks. They got a free speech and a tourist. The police in the trucks. Too many say they're Jesus. One of them's gonna be wrong. It's a protest singer. He's singing his protest song. He said, they wanna have a war. Keep you on your knees. They wanna have a war. Keep their factory. They wanna have a war to stop you buying Japanese. They wanna have a war to stop industrial disease. They pointing out an enemy. Keep you deaf and blind. Wanna sap your energy, incarcerate your mind. They give you poop, it's any gas, you fear, praise, sweet. 2 weeks in a Spaniard, Sunday strip of cheese. Meanwhile, cause Jesus says I cure it soon. I'd abolish Monday mornings, Friday afternoons. No one's having hunger strike, but dying by the green. Maybe even Jesus gets industrial.
Across the country in New Zealand to hello out in TV land.
Set. Is all this stuff working? Unbelievable. Everybody's singing so far away. Yeah, so far I just can't sing it. So far away from me. You're so far away.
That's very nice, very nice.
But I mean a long bit all of you. And you're so far away from me. Out on the telephone, cause you're so far away from me. All right. So far away from me. So far, I just can't see. So far away from me. You're so far.
Thank you. love swagger Romeo. He's got the suits of the night. Laying everybody low with a love song that he made. He finds that sweet life. He steps out of the shade. He says something like, you and me, baby. Juliet says, well, 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 it's home. You nearly give me a heart attack. He's underneath the window, she's singing, hey, there, my boyfriend's back. He shouldn't come around here, singing up with people like that. Anyway, what you gonna do about it? Juliet, the dice was loaded from the score. To realize it was just that the time was wrong. Juliet. So we come up on different streets. They both were streets of shame. Both dirty, both mean. Yes, and the dream was just the same. I dreamed your dream for you, so now your dream is real. How can you look at me as if I'm just another one of your deals? When you can fall for chains of silver, you can fall for chains of gold. You can fall for pretty strangers and the promises they hold. You promised me everything, yeah, you promised me thick and thin. Say I'm Romeo. You know I used to have a scene with you. Juliet, when we made love, you used to cry. You said I love you like the stars above. I love you till I die. And there's a place for us. Yeah, on a movie song. So when you're gonna realize it was just that the time was wrong. Don't do the talk, no, like it's all on the TV. I can't do a love song like the way it's meant to be. I can't do everything, but I'll do anything for you. I can't do anything except be in love with you. And all I do is miss you. All I do is keep the beat, rock and roll company. And all I do is kiss you through the bars of a rhyme. Julie, I do the stars with you, babe. Anytime. Julie, when we made love, you used to cry. You said I love you like the stars above. You said I love you till I die. And there's a place. So when you're gonna realize it was just at the time.
drives that street light. Boy steps out of the shade, he says, you and me, babe, how about it? Yeah, you and me, babe, so how about it?
driver's expenses, confidential information, send a diary. This is my investigation. It's not a public inquiry. Checking out a report, I'm digging up the dirt. Now you get to meet all sorts, and this is the line of work. Treachery and treason, there's always an excuse for it. And when I find a reason, I can't get used to it. Where do they go? At the end of the day, what have you got? You can take away and a bottle of whiskey, and you set our eyes and the blinds on the window and a pain. We'll be right back.
trouble and colour lights gonna play you bad thing. Maddie doesn't mind if it doesn't make that fancy sing. Got a daytime job, is doing quite alright, thank you very much. Little honky tonk, just like anything. Save it up all the Friday night. With the Sultans. With the Sultans. They're just fooling around in the corner. Suppose their baggies in the best king's wool. You don't give a damn about another trumpet playing band. Anyone they call in a rock. But the Sultan. We're the Sultans of Lake
baby. See this world as maybe said. Some people can be bad. The things they do, the things they say. But baby, I'll chase away those bitter tears. I'll chase away those restless fears that turn your blue skies into gray. They should be laughter pain. They should be sunshine after rain. These things have always been the same. So why worry now? Why worry now? Down, I turn to you. You make sense of what I do. And I know it isn't hard to say. But baby, in this world seem mean and cold, your love comes shining red and gold. All the rest is by the way. So why worry? There should be laughter after pain. There should be sunshine after rain. These things have always been the same. So why worry?
the talking blues. He got the action, he got the motion. Yeah, the boy can play. Dedication, he got the motion. Turning on the nighttime in the day. Song about the scene of my mama. Song about the night. Yeah, do the walk. So walk on by. Oh yeah, walk on by.
Jack's gonna take a picture of you. Hey, Jackie. Jack. Yeah, man, yeah. Francis Ford Sonny. Well, nice to see the fans, nice to see a few tourists too. Gonna introduce you to the Dire Straits rock and roll band. On the bass guitar we have Mr. John Hillsley. Going through his film noir period on guitar, Mr. Jack Sonni. Film saxophone, Mr. Chris White. Sporting the new surfing look on keyboards, Guy Fletcher. On drums we have what makes up part of the Welsh contingent, Mr. Terry Williams. Keyboards, Alan Clark. Oh, Jack, you need a nice... Where are you? Where is he? Oh, there he is. Pose it, man, pose it. Yeah. Yeah. Really, that sounds strange. I just broke a nail doing that little dance with you, man. You know that?
You got some clippers?
I'm just going to bite as I go, if you know what I mean.
Hang on.
Such an animal!
Right?
Such an animal!
See, I've only got half of it, so the best thing to do is get rid of this half. And then... just do it in the raw.
Alright.
Get some clippers from somewhere, man. I'm all shook up.
Shaking and his knees wasn't up. She thought that he was kinda neat.
and low and far away from home. Upstairs, Papa kissed Mama. He loves the career. Said that he's too young to too young to love us. Gonna wish him every happy day. Was the last day of summer. Come and walk home my hand.
yes, yes, she really turned me on. What's that? Hawaiian noise banging on the marbles like a chimpanzee. That ain't working. No, that's the way you do it. To put it for nothing, it takes four. We got to install microwave ovens, custom kitchen delivery. That's the way you do it, man. You play that guitar on the TV. That ain't working. That's the way you do it. Your money for nothing and your chicks for free. You get the money for nothing and the chicks for free. You get the chicks for free. Money for nothing and the chicks for free. You get the chicks for free. Oh, money. Get the chicks for free. Get the chicks for free. Money for nothing.
themselves in the carnival arcade. I'll be searching everywhere, steeplechase but palisade. In any shooting gallery where promises are made. But I rock away, rock away. Rock away, rock away. From Calico Woods and Whitley Bay. How to rock away. Girl, it looks so pretty to me. Like it always did. Like the Spanish city to me. When we were kids. Girl, it looks so pretty to me. Like it always did. Oh, like the Spanish city to me. When we were
my home is the lowlands. And always will be. Someday you'll return to your valleys and farms, and you'll no longer burn to be brothers in arms.
Thank you.
shush, I want quiet for a moment. There's a very personal and thanks to the band for a start, but they've got a personal thanks to a lot of Australia. And to show their personal thanks, first of all, I'd like to bring out the Health Minister, Dr. Blewett, and please, none of this booing, Dr. Blewett, and Sister Marie Hannon from the St. Vincent's Hospital. She's the administrator from St. Vincent's Hospital. From Dire Straits, and from Alan, from John, from Terry, from Mark, to Chris, to Jack, and to Guy, and from Guy, and another guy, their manager, and their manager, Ed Bicknell, for the drug campaign in this country. Tonight they're donating $50,000. So I'd like to, on behalf of Dire Straits, hand it over to Dr. Blewett, our health minister.
On behalf of the Commonwealth Government and St. Vincent's Hospital, I'd like to thank Mark and all the band for this very generous $50,000 donation to our anti-drug campaign. And I'd like to take the opportunity now to thank the band for all of the work it's done to support our national campaign against drug abuse. And I know I speak for all of you when I thank them too for what's been a mind-blowing show tonight. Thank you.
All right, the band are going to kill me for this, but for all you out there in television land, you haven't seen the impromptu musical efforts we've had from the band during the commercial breaks. They did one that was great, Waltzing Mathilda. The only way we, in this country, when we applaud a winner of our own, is to sing Waltzing Mathilda as one of our national songs. If the band would do the accompaniment, I want all of you 12,000 on behalf of Australia and New Zealand to at least join in and sing Waltzing Mathilda. That's our way of thanking you.
Thank you. All right, now we've done about, I can't remember how many shows it is, about 230. This is the last one on the tour. It's been a pretty big one. In fact, I think it's been the biggest one ever. And the first people I'd just like to thank very quickly for making it that way is the band. I think that we did all those shows, and I don't think they ever played a bad one for me. So thanks, lads, very much. And secondly, I'd just like to thank this amazing road crew of ours who are all heroes, including the Aussies, isn't it? It's not usual that you'll find us thanking promoters and stuff, but Gary Van Egmond is a happening gentleman, and he's done a very good job over here, and all his people, as well as our own Mr. Ed Bicknell and all of the damage management people, Paul Cummins, etc. So, finally, just want to thank everybody here down here in Australia and everybody who's watching in New Zealand as well. This is a great time. So we'll see you down the road sometime, okay? Now you be good to one another. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Thank you. It is.
How do you feel? What holiday are you going to take?
I'm going home, mate. I'm going home.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You enjoyed it?
Oh, loved it.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's great. It's
have you ever worked so hard in the last 12 months?
I've worked pretty hard. I've also had a really, pretty relaxed time as well.
All right. Yeah. Yeah. John?
Thanks, Bobby.
Thank you very much, and thank you.
You're nice one.
Yeah, you take care.
See you again.
Yeah, for sure. Mark? Thanks again, mate.
All
right, we won't see you for a while.
Yeah.
Okay. See you, fellas. See you, Ed. All right, they're just leaving the entertainment centre now. It's been a great concert. It's been a great telecast. We'll all take a breather, and we'll be back in a moment. Okay, well, that brings us to the end of this entire historical, I think, broadcast. It's one that's gone to New Zealand. It's a group that has taken the time to spend a lot of time in both New Zealand and Australia, to go to places, including Townsville, Rockhampton, to start off the concert in Australia and Hobart, that have taken the time to go to the Australian people. They couldn't go to everyone. And then they took the time, when they hate television, to do a live show. You've seen it tonight. I think it's an effort in itself. When you talk about Dire Straits fans, they're leaving the audience now, and it comes from this young one here. Say hello.
Hello.
To right up, as I said before, from 6 to 60. It's been worthwhile, and tonight, as I said before, Waltzing Mathilda, thank you, Dire Straits, not only for spending the time in this country and giving us great entertainment, but also for taking the care about the problems that we face this country. I hope you've enjoyed tonight's telecast. There's one team I want to thank, is the excellent Channel 9 team who've covered tonight, and I include them all, and I've got to especially thank Peter Feynman. It's been a hard job tonight, and I thank you, Peter, because your direction has been brilliant. I'll say good night, and it's back to all the stations, back to my hometown, where I'm sure Daryl and Ozzy and the team are ready to go again. Thank you, Australia, and good night, New Zealand. All right?
Some people think it's smart to play with hard drugs. But last year in Australia, hard drugs killed over 300 people. That doesn't sound very smart to me.
Drugs. Smart people don't touch them.
Young, what will we leave in this town?
Shh, someone's coming.
Australia has begun a $100 million offensive against drugs.
An offensive which has brought tougher penalties for drug offenders. An offensive which has linked Australia to drug enforcement agencies around the world. An offensive which is reaching into schools and teaching our kids to say no to drugs. An offensive which is reaching into their lives through their music, TV, and magazines. An offensive which has led to the creation of jobs and job training. An offensive which is providing help to those who have already fallen victim.
What will we leave them this time?
Our kids deserve a better deal. Through the drug offensive, your governments are making sure they get it.